Hi, welcome to this special edition of NECA Newscast. Today we have a discussion on one of the hottest topics in the electrical construction industry, design build, straight from two of the country's leading experts on the topic. John Mazel is the publisher of Electrical Contractor Magazine, and Lisa Washington is the executive director of the Design Build Institute of America. The information they're about to share with us is invaluable to electrical contractors, building owners, general contractors, or anybody with a stake in the electrical construction market. They talk about what design build is, how it is saving money for owners and operators right now, and how you can make sure your next job can be a design build project from your local NECA contractor.
There are several key elements that make up design build. First is the singular responsibility, and that there is one party that's accountable to the owner, and that's an important part of design build. Another important part of design build is the collaboration and integration among the team, and the fact that all parties are at the table and there's a mutual level of respect of the knowledge that each party brings to the table. So all of those elements are brought together up front in the process. I think the third important component is that in design build project delivery, unlike traditional design bid build, we really consider it purchasing a service, not a product, because you're constructing something based on an owner's performance requirements, not on prescriptive specifications.
Design build and its various combinations, permutations, if you will, various things of design build, design assist, has totally changed the role of the electrical contractor in the overall design specification and build process. It really brings a different set and a collaborative set of ideas to the table, of which the electrical contractor becomes a critical part.
Some informal research was done about 10 years ago that suggested that all successful design build projects had one element in common, and that was early integration of the team, in particular the subcontractors, especially contractors on the team.
When you get to a contractor or a firm that is 20 employees or more, we're finding that over 80% of their revenue is derived from participation in design build projects. That's significant.
We are even seeing more specialty contractors becoming the prime contractor on design build projects because of the extensiveness of their knowledge. There's an example of one right here in DC, the Schools Without Walls. There was a very tight deadline to get a school open in time for the school year. It was a design bid build project that had just gone awry. An electrical contractor was brought in to put that project back on schedule. 80% of the design had been done in the electrical area, and they started from scratch late in the game, got that project completed on time, actually ended up building additional classrooms because some of their knowledge resulted in a redesign that saved space in the electrical units in the building. And it's just a great example of how design build and the role of the electrical contractor can really make a huge difference in a project in both cost and schedule. There has been steady growth in design build over the past 10 years. It is predicted by DBIA and some research through McGraw-Hill that by 2015, design build will account for probably a little over 50% of all design and construction in the United States.
There are some who will be very slow to adopt, and unfortunately, they're gonna pay the price for that, because it really is the preferred method.
It gives them flexibility. The owner should also keep in mind that in design build, they get a commitment on price and schedule, which is going to make sure that those change orders don't happen. And if they do happen, there are consequences. You know, there are legal actions that they can take.
If it's a building, it's a candidate for design build, quite honestly.
Design build has been tested and proven to save on average 6% in cost, 12% in construction time, and projects are completed about 33% faster. That's very important all the time, but particularly in a down economy.